This video is made possible by the support of Squarespace. I use Squarespace for PremierGal.com. With the website, I'm able to easily drag and drop new logos, such as my Pride Month logo to celebrate Pride. And you can save, and now the logo's up to date. I also keep all of my gear up to date just by dragging and dropping images and adding links with just a click of a button. And you can go to squarespace.com/premiergal and get 10% off to get started to make a site to promote your own YouTube channel. And it'll give you lots of templates to start from. And now here's the tutorial on how to clone yourself in Premiere Pro.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to Gal. In this video, I'm gonna show you how I clone myself.
Excuse me, I'm doing my introduction here. Nobody likes these introductions.
Just get to the tutorial. That's what they're here for.
Not true at all.
No, people like to get set up.
You guys, just fast forward.
Why? Just fast forward.
So first off, why would you even want to clone yourself? Well, cloning has been done by many a cappella musicians like Mike Tompkins for doing cool music videos showing how he plays multiple instruments. And also in Hollywood, such as Parent Trap, where Lindsay Lohan was duplicated to make it look like she had a twin. Now to clone myself, I used a tripod to film myself in four different locations doing four different things. So you see here, I'm setting up the lights in different locations and I'm not crossing paths with the other gals in the scene. So then I got four different shots recorded with the tripod and this is what they looked like all next to each other here. But then the next step is to take this into Premiere Pro and then add a mask to each layer to produce this awesome effect. So let's go ahead and jump on in. So just to break it down here, I filmed this all in one take and I just chopped it up and stacked them on top of each other. So you have video layer 1, 2, 3, and 4. So right over here, if I turn off video layer 4, you can see that I go away. If I turn off video layer 3, the gal on the left disappears. And if I turn off video layer 2, I disappear on the right. And then the main video clip is me coming to sit down, which is the base clip. So I come into screen here, then video layer 2 is on. And what I did is I created an opacity mask. So you can see the mask that I created over here. So I basically only am showing this part of the frame so that way I don't cut over top of me sitting here in the chair. Now let me turn on video layer 3. Same thing, opacity mask, but on the right. So you can see I have a mask around me here on the left. And then over here, if I turn on this layer, this is a little bit more complex of a mask because I had to go around this light here. If you click on this, you can see what that looks like. So let's go on over here to the demo and you can see I have all four clips here stacked on top of each other, but we have to get started here. So you see if I turn off all these layers, it's just me sitting there. So I come into frame and I sit down. Now let me turn on the second layer here. And this is me walking in frame on the right. So I'm not here. I need to draw a mask around me. So to do that, what I'm going to do is just select video layer 2 and then go up to opacity and select the pen tool. And I'm just going to click, 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 and click. Now this one's pretty easy mask because there's not too much intersecting going on. There is a moment where my hand reaches out. So see right here, I just have to be careful that my hand doesn't overlap here because what happens if I go like this, you can see it cuts off my hand and my body. So you gotta keep it over here, but also make sure that this light stand is fully there. All right, so that mask is done and that looks good. You can also add a little bit of feathering around the mask so that way it blends in better. So if I click off, you can see you don't see the mask at all. If I click back on and I don't add any feathering on the mask, if it's 0, you can see there's a little bit of a line there. It's very subtle, but just so it blends in, I highly recommend adding in a mask so it just blends in much better. All right, so this mask is done. Now let's go to video layer 3 and I need to add a mask. Go to opacity, click on the pen tool, and I'm just going to click, 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 and click. All right, so now we have this mask, and you can reduce this down to 50% so you can bring it off screen like so. And that should work. So then you just fit. And now you can also add some feathering as well, just a little bit. And now we have three of the gals here. So now when we play it back and kind of scrub through, you can see that there's a problem here. So what happened is that this layer here comes in too early because it's cutting me off below. So to fix that, I'm just going to shift it over. So when I come into frame here and I sit down, that's when this layer of me coming in on the right can come in. So I can roll this edit back and move this over. And so there we go, we're in scene. So then the last clip, we turn it on. This is where I just come in at the last minute. So as I come in over here on the right, I'll just roll this edit back. And then I'll create a mask. And then we can refine it. So let's go up to Effect Controls, go to Opacity, and then just quickly draw a mask around here. And once I close the mask, you'll see me appear in the other scenes because these exist below this, okay? So what we need to do now is make sure that this mask goes directly around this light so it doesn't cut it off. So this is where I zoom in to 150% and I hit the Alt Option key to make this rounded like so and really get this as close as possible around the edge here. And then we can scrub through just to make sure that my shoes don't get in front of the mask. So then here, that works. And then just here, my foot gets cut off. So we need to drag that down like so until my feet are in the shot. And I can add another point just so my hand doesn't get in the shot. So that's how we did the last one. And then we're done. We have four different masks, four different gals in the scene, and this is the final effect.
So I hope that you guys enjoy this awesome tutorial and put it to practice and start cloning yourself for your next project. If you guys have any questions at all, be sure to leave a comment below. I like to see what you guys say, so be sure to do that. And also give this video a thumbs up if you like this type of tutorial. If it gets to 1,000 likes, that would be super cool. And if you guys want direct message support or some templates that I design myself each month, you guys can head on over to patreon.com/premieregal and become a patron. So that's all for this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.